This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, in this video, we're going to define what a radian measure of an angle is. So first of all, the most common way of measuring angles is in degrees. Most people have heard of that. But another measure for angles is called radian measure. And this measure is used in trigonometry, calculus, and science. So a radian is simply a real number. It's not like 10 degrees. It's like, well, this angle measures 5, or this angle measures 2/3, etc. So you could actually say an angle measures 2 radians, or you can just put 2, this is an abbreviation, just putting R-A-D, or you could simply write that the angle's measure is 2. You don't have to write the word radians. So it's a little bit strange. You've got an angle, but you're just saying it's a number. So if you don't see the degree symbol, the angle is not in degrees. So it's very important if you're trying to show a measure of angle and you mean 20 degrees, you need to put the degree symbol, because if you don't, it means 20 radians, and you'll find out that's a totally different angle. So what is a radian? How do we measure an angle in radians? It's kind of a mouthful. It takes a little thinking to get used to the idea. So here I'm going to explain how we're going to do it. You're going to draw a circle of radius r, and then you're going to draw an angle, I'll call it theta. So the vertex of that angle is at the center of the circle, and you're going to use an arrow to show the direction the angle is going. And we're going to have it go counterclockwise to be positive angle. The angle cuts off an arc on the circle, and if that arc has length s, I don't know why, but they use the letter s for the length of an arc, and the angle is opening counterclockwise, like I said we'll do, the radian measure of theta is defined as theta equals s over r. Okay, so let's see how. that's quite a mouthful, so you sort of have to think about that, maybe read it more than once. Let's try it. So what's it say to do? You're going to draw a circle. So that's step one. So I have a circle here, and it said to do it of radius r. So from the center to any point on the circle is r. That might be 2 feet, it might be 5 inches, etc. It's just some number. All right, then what? Draw an angle so the vertex is at the center of the circle. All right, so let's do that. So now we're going to draw an angle. So I'm going to take and how about I just start it right here? Whoops. Have to undo that. And let's say I go up to here. Okay? And I'm going to call that theta. So this is still a length of r, right? Because from the center to any point is a length of r. All right, so we drew an angle, so the vertex is the center of the circle, using an arrow to show the direction. Okay, I want to show that it's going, I didn't really show that little arrow first, it's going this way, right? So we'll say that's theta. The angle cuts off an arc on the circle. All right, so what I'm talking about here is this right here. And I'm going to show that with an arrow as well for now, even though it's just the length. And I'm going to call that S. All right, so here's the picture. So hopefully you're okay so far. If that arc has length S, here it is, right? And the angle is opening counterclockwise, which it is, the radian measure of theta is equal to S over R. So we take this angle measure, we say we take the length of this blue line here, the dark blue, and divide it by the radius, and that is the measure of theta. That is the definition of the radian measure of theta. It's like you get out the dictionary, and that's what it says. All right. So we have this definition. If we have this picture, Then theta is S over R. I'm going to go ahead and just get rid of this R here just so we could see basically what it looks like. That's our central angle. Central angle just means that the vertex is at the center for theta. Right, so it's the length of this arc, right? Like you could measure that somehow. And then you could divide it by the radius. That's the angle measure in radians for theta. All right, now what about if the circle has a radius of 1? Then we would have theta equals S over 1, right? Since R is 1, or we could just say theta equals S. So some people like to think of it this way for the how to think about what radians really mean. Say, well, if you have a measure, if you have a circle that's always just a radius of 1, then however long that arc length is, that's the same as the measure of this angle. So it's kind of an interesting thing. The measure of theta is the same as the length of S. Okay, but that only works in a unit circle, so that if the circle has radius of 1. Okay, so you still may be wondering, okay, let's, you know, what more is there to this? I'm not really getting any real numbers. I'm not getting a number sense yet. So let's go ahead and think about what 1 radian is first. All right, so let's say we want to know what 1 radian is. Basically, remember that theta equals S over R. So the question is, how do I make that equal to 1? It means the radius and the arc length have to be the same number to have it be 1. So that's how big a radian is. You can look at a picture here. Imagine if you had a string and you measured this radius, and then you took that string along the circle and wherever it ended, that means this arc length is the same as the radius. Then I would get theta here. I would have R over R, which is equal to 1. Same thing over here. If I have this is a unit circle. A unit circle just means the radius 1. So here we have a unit circle, which means we have a radius of 1. If you're looking at that, it's the same thing. You would get 1 over 1, which is 1. So some people always think of, well, I want to have any circle at all. I just think of it S over R. For people who like to deal with a unit circle, it's just whatever the length of the arc length is, because you're always just putting it over 1. So those are two examples. So if you look at this picture here, no, it looks like it's more than 45 degrees, which it is. And later you're going to find out, you know, more exactly or closer or approximately how many degrees this is. But just notice that 1 radian is a lot bigger than 1 degree. 1 degree is tiny, right? Because, I mean, you can't even draw it. It's so tiny on this piece of paper I have anyway. So it's important that you say this is 1 radian. If you put 1 degree, you're way off, because 1 degree is like so tiny, it's like, you know, tinier than that. Very, very small. So be careful. If you want to write something in radians, you do not use the degree symbol. So this has just been an introduction to the definition of radian measure, so that we have an understanding of just what it means. And now you want to see my video showing how to convert between radians and degrees. So we'll be doing that especially for the special angles in degrees, such as 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 90 degrees, etc. You know, there's lots and lots of special angles, and we're going to see how would we write these in radian measure.
This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.